Sources say Andrew Puzder, the president's pick for labor secretary, has just moments ago withdrawn his nomination. He was set to testify before a Senate committee tomorrow morning. CNN senior congressional reporter Manu Raju joins me now. Manu, what happened?
Well, Jake, he didn't have the support. And in fact, actually, just moments ago, Sean Spicer confirming this news on the record, telling reporters that he withdrew and that the president is going to have a statement soon. But this after hours, Jake, I am told, of Republicans sending the message to the White House that he did not have the support to get confirmed. A message first conveyed last night, I am told, by a source, as well as this morning. They said that there were four firm no votes on the Republican side. And up to 11 no votes on the Republican side as well. So that means that Puzder's chances of confirmation were incredibly slim. There were a whole bunch of liabilities piling up from his views on immigration that some folks on the right did not like because he was a little bit too moderate, but also some personal liabilities from the past, including a messy divorce from some three decades ago involving domestic abuse allegations that have since been withdrawn. But at that time, his ex-wife appeared on the Oprah Winfrey Show to discuss the issues of abuse, and that tape has been viewed by members on the committee considering his nomination, and we actually obtained a copy of that tape as well. Take a look at what we have found.
The most frightening thing was leaving, because once I made that break and once I made it public, and remember, my ex-husband was a public figure. Everyone knew him and knew what he was doing. And once I made that public, he vowed revenge. He said, I will see you in the gutter. This will never be over. You will pay for this.
Now, Jake, his ex-wife has actually since regretted going on the show. She actually sent a letter to the committee saying, look, I should not have done that. He's a good man. He's a kind man. He was not abusive. She says that she was manipulated. That's why she leveled those domestic abuse charges. She said she went on the Oprah show only to get a, quote, free trip to Chicago. But nonetheless, these things were bound to get aired at that confirmation hearing, which was scheduled for tomorrow. And it would have been potentially a very ugly confirmation process. And some Republicans just did not want to go through with it. And they wanted Donald Trump to pull back from the nomination. It's one reason why, probably the biggest reason why, Andrew Puzder said that he couldn't go through it with it himself, Jake.
And also there's this case of the undocumented immigrant that he had as working at his house, and he only paid taxes on that individual recently. Is there any one issue that the Republicans who were withdrawing their support or expressing ambivalence cited as the reason why they could not support him?
You know, it was a sum total of events. Some were very troubled by that episode, Jake, that you referenced, not hiring an undocumented immigrant, but also just a number of issues continuing to pile up. And this, the timing is also important here. Republicans had just taken a political hit for backing Betsy DeVos to be education secretary, as well as other controversial picks like Rex Tillerson to run secretary of state, some nominee that a lot of Republicans did not want to support, but ultimately did. This was a bridge too far with all the things that are piling up against him, and some conservatives on the outside coming forward opposing his nomination. One thing, Jake, I'm hearing some finger pointing as well. Republicans are angry that the outside groups, big business groups, did not spend enough money to protect him. So some finger pointing happening as well, Jake.